Michelle Glass here, and our job for this presentation is the lower appendage, and we're going to be studying here muscles and four spinal nerves. So to begin, we are looking at the back lateral side of the model. This muscle right here is the gluteus maximus. This is on our chart for origin, insertion, and action. The job of the gluteus maximus is to extend or medially rotate the thigh. So the insertion would be the femur, and then the origin would be up here. So that's going to be on the ilium, the sacrum, and the coccyx. If we go ahead and dissect the gluteus maximus, we can see underneath, right where that Velcro is, the gluteus medius. And you can also see right here the sciatic nerve, which I will come back to. Now, what I like to do with my thigh is to work my way all the way around the thigh. So I start with the back lateral side, and I continue on the lateral side until I get back to the back. So that's what I'm gonna do here. So remember, I have already dissected off my gluteus maximus. I found my gluteus medius, so as I work my hand around, my next muscle here is the tensor fasciae latae. Continuing around, I get to my rectus femoris. So rectus, remember, means straight. Femoris is for the femur. The rectus femoris is part of the quadriceps femoris group, so that's a group of four muscles on the front side of the thigh. So in addition to the rectus femoris, I'm going to label my vastus lateralis on the lateral side, vastus medialis on the medial side, and then underneath the rectus femoris, I can see here my vastus intermedius. So these three vastus muscles plus my rectus femoris make up my quadriceps femoris group. So working my hand back up to the top of the thigh, my next muscle is my sartorius. It's this long ribbon. You can dissect the sartorius off, which helps you to see the iliosus a little bit better. Iliosus is the combined iliacus muscle and psoas major, which I showed you on that torso model. Remember, iliacus is actually visible here. You can see the psoas major here. Psoas major, remember, is spelled with a silent P, S-O-A-S. So the iliosus does have a silent P in it, I-L-I-O-P-S-O-A-S. From the iliosus, you next can find your femoral nerve. This small piece right here is the pectineus. AD, adductor longus, gracilis, adductor magnus here, going underneath the gracilis and underneath the sartorius. So let me stick it back in place. So there's my sartorius back in place. So I can still see my iliosus with the silent P, my femoral nerve, pectineus, adductor longus, gracilis, adductor magnus here and here. Coming around to the back side, I have my hamstring group. These are antagonistic to the quadriceps femoris group. The hamstrings consist of three muscles, and we are on the back side of the thigh. On the medial side, you have two muscles. The semitendinosus is on top of the semimembranosus, which you can see on the side view here and here. And if I dissect it off, you can see it underneath. On the lateral side of the hamstring, we have the biceps femoris. If I dissect off my hamstring group, I get an even better view of my sciatic nerve. Notice my sciatic nerve branches, and here I'm going to see one branch going straight down the back of the tibia. That's the tibial nerve. And then the other branch is coming around on the lateral side. That is my fibular nerve. Now, dissected from my calf is this muscle here. So there will be muscles on top of those nerves. Okay, let us continue with our lower appendage by looking at the leg, which remember is extending from the knee to the ankle. So this consists of two bones, the tibia and the fibula. So right here is the tibia, and sitting on top of that is the tibialis anterior muscle. Next, right here, we can see the extensor digitorum longus, which has tendons going to each of the toes. The muscle that's going to extend the big toe is the extensor hallucis longus. So that tendon goes to the big toe. Here we can see the fibularis longus and the fibularis brevis. And then here at the back, we can see the gastrocnemius. And underneath that, you have the soleus. You can dissect off the gastrocnemius and soleus piece of your model. So here we're seeing gastrocnemius. Here I can take one of those bellies off to reveal the soleus. Or I can look at it this way. So this is the soleus here. Looking at the back of, what is it, the bottom of the foot, I have the flexor digitorum. Oh, I've lost it. Brevis. Flexor digitorum brevis. And then on the side here, I have my abductor digiti minimi or digiti minimi. And that's it for the lower appendage.